Good day everyone. Up till our previous lecture, we were mainly talking about the hardware part of the flight controller. However, the software component of the flight component plays an equally important role in controlling the drone. The aim of the present lecture is to introduce you to the software component of the flight controller. Understanding the software and programming the software is important to gain precise control of the drone and its operations. Let's see how do we achieve this using the various software stacks that are present with the flight controller. The PX4 flight stack is a powerful, fully featured autopilot. This project supports multiple vehicle types, also has an active developer community. The most famous platform that runs the PX4 flight stack is some of the drones from Munich. On the surface, you can consider PX4 flight stack to be similar to Autopilot, as there is a lot of hardware that can run either PX4 or Autopilot firmware. Similarly, since both systems use the same telemetry protocol, MavericSoft, a lot of software is also compatible with both, such as Q-Control Ground. It is only when you get to very specific functions you may notice some variations between the two projects. However, in terms of core autonomous functions, PX4 and Autopilot are very similar. PX4 uses BSD while Autopilot uses GPL. This makes PX4 more attractive for commercial use since you don't need to make your modifications open source. With Autopilot, any changes need to be shared as open source. So if you plan to develop some special function that you want to keep private or sell, PX4 is the way to go. This is why PX4 is more attractive for business use. INAV is essentially a fork of Betaflight that focuses on adding autonomous drone functions rather than the racing features. This lets the software fly your drone to waypoints or return home all on its own. This firmware supports most of the racing flight controllers. INAV also supports both multi-rotors and fixed-wing aircraft. If you already have an racing flight controller and want to have full for autonomous control with an easy-to-use, familiar clean flight style GUI, INAV is a great option. LiberPilot aims to be a general flight control autopilot that supports both fixed and rotor wing aircraft. The GUI is an excellent piece of software. The firmware itself is also solid and great to work with, and so on. The only downside is that there are not many as features as Autopilot, but this is mainly because this project is not as popular, so has fewer developers in the community. If you want to run a powerful but cheap Autopilot platform, LiberPilot is a great option for you. After you have installed all of the equipment into your multi-rotor, the next step is to program the flight controller. This may appear to be a daunting task, but if you just follow the steps outlined here, you will find that this process is simple, easy, and quick. Plus, most controllers have a good variety of programming options that let you tweak the multirotor's controls to fit your flying style. First, the right connection. The first step is to make sure you have the right receiver channels connected to the correct flight controller channels. The order will generally be aileron, elevator, throttle, and rudder. The fifth and the sixth channel will be connected to three-way switches on your transmitter and used for flight mode and flight orientation. SBUS receivers makes this process easy because only one plug needs to be installed between the receiver and the flight controller. Next is software installation. With the receiver and the flight controller properly connected, the next step will be to download the appropriate controller software. Most controller programs are set up to run on personal computers. With the controller software downloaded and installed, connect the flight controller to the computer with a micro or mini USB plug. Start the software and plug the battery into the multi-rotor so that there is power to the receiver, which can now communicate with the transmitter. It's a good idea to do this before you have installed the propellers on your multi-rotor also. First step is to let the program know what type of multi-rotor you have. Is it 3, 4, 6, or 8 blade? Then you can move on to setting the stick controls. Many programs have a transmitter motor that shows the stick movement in the relationship to the controller. By watching the monitor while you move the stick, you can instantly see if all the channels are connected correctly and if any of them need to be reversed. Some controllers require a stick fabric calibration, so the flight controller knows just how far your transmitter stick travels. If that's needed, the program will guide you through the steps. When all of the stick channels are correctly synchronized, you can move on to programming the switches. Multi-rotor stabilization. The switches can be used to program in stabilization modes, flight modes, and various other functions depending on what you have attached to the multi-rotor, which could include camera gimbals, retractable landing skids, or motor cutoff. The main switch that needs programming is the one used for stabilization mode on the multi-rotor. This is generally programmed to one of the three-way switches. I like to program in GPS mode, altitude hold mode, and manual mode. Again, the transmitter monitor in the flight controller program will show that switches are activating these modes, and if necessary, they can be changed or adjusted. If you would like a certain switch for this program function, program it through your transmitter menu for that channel. I usually need to change the endpoints of that channel on the switch to coordinate the proper switching parameters on the controller. While the programming itself is done in the transmitter menu, by watching the transmitter monitor on the flight controller program, you can see easily when the correct parameters are achieved. Next is the flight modes. The second main switch to be programmed is generally for flight modes. Each controller manufacturer has a different name for flight orientation or flight modes. There are three main ones. Nose lock, the flight orientation is always based on the nose of the aircraft. Post lock, orientation is established when the multirotor starts up and continues in that orientation regardless of which direction the nose is pointed during the flight. For example, if you were standing directly behind the multirotor when it took off, it would not matter when the direction of the which direction nose of the aircraft is pointing during the flight. The transmitter stick orientation would always remain the same. Home point orientation. This flight mode uses the point of takeoff as its absolute orientation regardless of the flight position of the aircraft. In this position, if you input right or left, the multirotor would circle around the point of takeoff. Setting up these three-way switch is exactly the same as setting up all the others. Adjust the endpoints of the switch in the transmitter menu while looking at the program's transmitter monitor. After you have finished setting up the switches, label the position and relevance of each switch, finally keeping it level or a level flight. Some flight controller programs allow you to see the orientation and horizon of the aircraft and adjust it accordingly. This ensures that the stabilization programming is working in the correct direction. Another feature which will allow you to independently start up each of the motors to check that each one is moving in the correct direction. If it is not, just switch on two of the three wires coming from the speed controller to reverse the direction of the motor. To summarize, we looked at the PX4 flight stack, INAV program, the Liber Pilot program, and finally, how do we program a flight controller? I think we are now ready to get the flight controller and program it as per our requirement. The next chapter talks about getting the appropriate batteries which can power the entire system. Let us meet in the next chapter now. Thank you very much.